Yo, what's up? It's your boy Extreme Mexcal, and welcome back, players, to another video. Another movie of Red Dead Redemption. This is part 4 of the movie. I was busy, that's why I didn't post. Plus, I had some problems with the iPhone recording of it, but that's another video. That's a rent video. That's a rent video because it's recording the last 3 minutes or 4 minutes of the game. I tried another challenge, a hard challenge at Faction Wars. Both of them, 3 of them, he recorded, the iPhone recorded the last 3 minutes. So, yeah, players. So, without further ado, let's dive in head first and see the movie part 4 of Red Dead Redemption. Let's go.
Dentro.
Chi sono sti buffoni?
Sono qui per picciotto.
Coi soldi?
Why do you take his son?
Excuse me.
I said, why did you take his son? We ain't got no problems with you, sir. Nor you with us. But if you want to start one, there's going to be a lot of folks dead in this room before it's done.
So, you walk into my city, stinking of shit and looking like this, and you come into my house before you have a bath and you tell me how to act? You ask me to show compassion. Have I not shown you almost infinite compassion already by simply allowing you to breathe in my presence?
Indeed you have. Now, we are simple country folk. All we have is each other. And you have gone and you have took his son over some dispute with some inbred ex-slavers. It ain't got nothing to do with any one of us.
You had nothing to do with destroying the liquor business!
We was innocent bystanders. And that which we weren't innocent of, well, we most surely were ignorant of.
You twist words, you lie shamelessly. You think you are better than everyone else. Teodoro. Date da bere sti uomini. Angelo Bronte.
Dutch Vanderland. Arthur Morgan. Arthur.
The pleasure is mine.
John Marston.
All mine, please.
So, can my friend have his son?
Of course, of course. But, should I be out of pocket over a misunderstanding? Of course I know, you would not want that, huh?
No.
No, no, no. So, how about this? You perform a simple job for me, and you get your son back.
What is it?
A couple of people have taken to grave robbing in the cemetery.
Oh, that is a fine place for it, the best.
I love this guy. I love you. See, they've taken not only to desecrating the dead, but they've done so without paying a tribute to the living. Thing is, they see my men. Of course, they're on a mile. So maybe you two head off, huh? And you, Mr. van der Linde, you tell me more about my manners. Salute.
Salute. Well, you took your time.
Jack, where's your host?
Like I said, you took your time.
I'm glad to see you.
Let's get going. What a fine man. Hey, friend, thank Mr. Bronte for everything.
Yeah, I'm fine.
Come on.
Hey! Someone needs to show you how to ride. Hey, they're back! I think I see Jack!
Abigail! Abigail! We got you, your son, everything!
We got him!
Mama!
He's fine!
I'm fine, Mama. They fed me good. Italian food. Did you ever eat that?
Come here, you silly boy. You got him. You got my son back. Dutch, Arthur, thank you. Thank you. I got my son back!
Jack! How are you, boy?
I'm fine, thanks.
Everything's okay now. Abigail?
Can I go play now?
So?
Well, we met Mr. Bronte. He is quite a character.
Is he now?
You ever meet an Italian strong man before?
Not outside of a circus.
Well, let me tell you all about him. John, you go be with your family. Arthur, thank you.
Boys, we got some work to do. Interesting work. But first, let's have a drink. We got Jack back!
Well, the boy's safe, thank goodness.
Everyone thank you, Arthur. I... I don't know how to say it. Thank you.
I understand. Come on. Do as Dutch says. Go be with your family.
Jose?
Hey, Arthur.
Come on! If we're gonna make it to this party, we sure as shit better clean up a little.
So we're doing this?
Oh, yeah. Old friend Dutch van der Linde is finally showing his true colors. Social climbing.
Old Signor Bronte, that horrendous snake, has invited us to the ball, Cinderella. So my suggestion is we go and get you a gown.
You son of a bitch.
We are ridiculous. Utterly.
I ain't never been to a ball in my life.
Nor have I, if I am being honest.
I used to quite often. There can be fine pickets.
Oh, no pickpocketing. We are here to make real contact.
What kind of contact?
Well, I don't know. We'll find what we can. All I know for sure is we are going to a party at the mayor's house, and the guest of honor is the worst crook in town. I am sure that we will find something.
Okay.
Gentlemen, Luca, I'm afraid the mayor does not allow guns at official functions after last year's incident. Luca here will take you to Mr. Bronte. I believe he is expecting you.
Follow me, gentlemen.
Angry cowboys, you've arrived, and you've washed per la prima volta questo mese senza dubbio.
This is quite a party you've invited us to.
Yes, quite something, although I'm not quite sure what.
So, this is Saint Denis High Society.
Yes, apparently so.
And all these people, these are friends of yours, Signor Bronte?
No, not quite. But they certainly are afraid of me, like that one. See, that wretch is the mayor. Henri Lemieux. You'll do anything for a dollar, and I mean anything.
Politics is a foul business. Yes.
Oh, and that one too. That is Alberto Fusar. He owns a sugar plantation out on the island, and he comes here to whore and despoil himself. Oh, and that is Hobart Crawley, a Confederate major in the war. I mean, hero, they say, but that is his very young wife. I mean, a young mistress, that's the natural order of things, yes, but a young wife is unseemly. Oh, the Redskins. I have no sympathy for them, because whoever is stupid enough to get tricked by the Americans, no, they get what they deserve, huh? Yes, hand a letter to the mayor. Oh, yeah, that'll save you. And that is Hector Fellows. Mm. This self-righteous newspaper man. Maybe you will kill him for me one day.
Well, we're not paid killers as such. Not in cold blood, anyway.
I did not know you were so particular that you wouldn't help a friend.
Oh, I'm willing to help in any way I can, within reason.
I'm going to pretend to understand what that means.
I meant no offense, sir.
None taken. None taken! All these vulgar people. They hate me. Non vedo l'ora di guardarti morire.
Well, it has been wonderful conversing with you, but I can tell that you are very busy, and I won't waste any more of your time.
Yes, yes, yes. Go, enjoy yourselves, and mingle with this vulgar scum. It'll make you long for the days when you could shoot each other and screw cows out on the open range.
Those sure were the days. Good day, gentlemen.
Good day to you. But before you go, what exactly are your plans here?
Well, we've not made any... Well, we are going to need some money.
Money, yes, of course. Well, there's money at the trolley station. They keep a lot of cash there in the day. Now, I could not involve myself in such matters. But you... As a guest, yes. As my guest, bah, do it, huh? Okay, good day, gentlemen.
Goodbye.
Okay, ragazzi, adesso il vino buono.
You are drunk, Ferdinand.
I'm not drunk, you fool. But this man loves darkies.
Hey, you are pretty drunk.
Thank you, sir.
My pleasure.
Henri Lemieux. I hope you're enjoying my party.
The mayor.
Allegedly.
There's quite a place you got here.
It's not mine, and the city is horribly in debt, but we can still put on a good show. Do you know Evelyn Miller?
My lord. The writer?
Well, we seem to have another deranged drunkard on our hands.
Shall we?
My lord, they're fantastic.
Monsieur, please. Mr. Cornwall was quite insistent, I'm afraid. He shouted down the telephone for several minutes.
Mr. Cornwall is a horse's ass, and a bad horse.
I'm very sorry, sir.
It's not your fault. I'm a fool for trusting him. I'll come in and sign it in a minute. Let me enjoy the fireworks.
Of course.
Can you say something about Cornwall?
Yes. Find out what.
Sure. Mr. Leviticus Cornwall. Top secret. Extremely confidential. Very interesting. Find anything? I think so.
Nothing. This town is a waste of time.
Maybe not.
Arthur? Gentlemen. I think we're done here.
What did you find out? Here comes Lenny. All right. Let's get in. Go home.
I ain't never felt so awkward in all my life. All them folk all so pleased with themselves. Oh, high society's pigeon shit. If you ask me, it's more like torture.
Well, that's sort of the point, isn't it? Let the people torture themselves.
Here's them papers I took.
Anybody see you take this?
I don't think so.
I might have an idea. Let me think on it. Interesting times.
I guess. So what's next? Dancing lessons? Deportment?
More along the lines of armed robbery. Jose is handling reconnaissance on the bank. He and Abigail are gonna run some distractions, see how the law reacts.
Good.
Oh, and I spoke to Evelyn Miller. Fine man. Here helping the Indian chief we saw.
Yeah, I met him too, with the mayor.
He's lobbying officials in Saint-Denis on their behalf. Maybe we could help.
Maybe.
Now, I think there's a lot of money on the riverboat. A lot of money. And Trelawney, he's investigating for us. He says to meet him at the tailor's.
Okay.
One big score down here, Arthur, and we disappear. We are almost heading home.
Where is home?
I don't know. Exactly. But I can smell it. I'm gonna go investigate this trolley thing old Bronte was talking about.
Okay.
Arthur! Arthur! Up here! You came!
Yeah, I came. So, what do you need?
Wait there. I'm coming straight down. Arthur.
Hello, Mary.
You came.
Sure. Whenever you call for me, I'll come.
Oh, Arthur.
What's wrong?
Daddy.
Your father? I'm a bigger fool than I even thought.
I'm begging you, Arthur. I know Daddy was not kind to you, but surely you cannot hate a man for the sin of loving his daughter and wanting better for her than
me?
Than the choices you
what
make.
What choice did I have? Did I ever have?
Oh, I know. You had to live by your code. But your code is... well, it's not right.
Has your way been right, Mary? With you and Jamie joining a bunch of crazies? And hypocritical daddy with his drinking and whoring and gambling? Huh? Is that what a pure life has gotten you? Begging me for help?
Oh, Arthur. Be kind to me. Please.
I'm sorry.
I am... I should have asked someone else. But...
but I'm the best guy you know at frightening decent people.
It wasn't that I didn't love you, Arthur. You know that.
Mama.
Oh, Arthur. We were so very young. Think how different life could have been.
Yeah, I think about it. A lot. It all seems so long ago and far away now.
Will you help me try to save Daddy?
Come along, Dan. Where are we going? What's the old lovable patriarch been up to now?
Oh, Arthur. You know sarcasm is beneath you. He's been gambling and drinking and other things.
Oh, the filthy rotter. Where can we find him?
He said he was going down to the Theodore Eckhart stables. Something about a horse. It's down by the water in the warehouse district near the train yard.
Come on, then.
Don't be a pompous ass, Arthur. It doesn't suit you.
Oh, should I leave that to Daddy?
Leave Daddy alone. He suffers enough.
Well, I suppose I can take some consolation in that.
Oh, Arthur. I should have ran away with you years ago.
Well, you wouldn't.
No, I didn't. But... well... I don't know. Let me go in and see what kind of a state he's in.
Sure. I'll wait here. Good luck. Scream if you need any help.
Very funny.
You can't stand there.
What, in the street?
Yes, in the street.
Is it your street?
Just get out of here.
Why?
I said, just get out of here.
Listen, partner. I'm waiting on a lady. She's a fine lady. She's just gone inside. If I wasn't waiting on this lady, you'd be dead already. But if you continue to irritate me, I'll kill you. And make my apologies to the lady, it's your call.
Oh, I didn't mean nothing.
Never been so demeaned in my life.
Apology accepted. Oh, wait, right there.
I have half a mind to kill you myself.
Daddy!
No!
Oh, Daddy, please, come home. You're tired, Daddy, tired and
I have no such thing. You get away from me, you head home. I insist upon it. Leave me be. Damn nuisance.
Excuse me, partner. Still as charming as ever, us.
Come here, quick.
Mind where you go. Mind where you go.
Sorry?
Do you think he saw us?
I don't think so.
What did you say to me?
I didn't say a thing insulting.
I'll wipe that goddamn smirk clean off your face.
Ain't you a little old for brawling, mister?
Damn you!
What's he doing? What do you think he's doing?
Well, he's either waiting for a woman of dubious morals, or he's trying to sell something.
So, Ashton, you got the money?
Seems he's selling something.
Have you got the brooch, Mr. Gillis?
Yes. Yeah.
Here's the money. That is beautiful.
It's a family heirloom.
That was mother's brooch.
Not any longer, Mr. Gillis. Enjoy the money. And should you need any more, I can offer you a loan at a very reasonable rate of interest.
No, thank you. I've heard what happens to folks who take loans from you.
It's not even his to sell.
It's just a brooch. At least he didn't get himself killed.
You don't understand. Mother left it to me. You sold my mother's brooch? How could you?
You!
That's theft!
Oh, speaking of thieves, I see you found your outlaw again.
Hello, sir. Have you been well?
Daddy, how could you?
Mary, wait here. I'll go get the brooch.
Don't hurt anyone, Arthur.
Father.
I don't know.
You want me to go find him again?
Not really.
Let's take a walk. I'll take you to the trolley.
Thank you.
Got you your brooch back.
I won't ask.
Probably best not.
Hey, what are you doing now, right this moment?
Why'd you ask?
Well, I was wondering if you wanted to do something. Head to the theater, perhaps.
Theater? Me? Sure, why not?
It'll be fun, Arthur. Let's go to the R'lure. They have the strangest acts.
Strangest I can handle. Well, it's the normal business of life. I can't seem to get a grip on.
You and me both, Arthur. Oh, I've missed you.
Don't start.
You're an idiot. But you'll always be my friend.
Well, of course I'm your friend, but you ain't always fair with me.
If I was fair with you and a good person, I'd have had you hanged a long time ago.
Well, that's true.
So, shut up and act like a gentleman, or at least try to for once in your brainless life.
You're not a very nice woman, Mrs. Lynn.
Well, look at the company I keep.
I know, it's quite dreadful, isn't it?
It's sort of beautiful. In a gaudy and tasteless way.
It's the only way I know.
Thank you.
Well, no, I didn't mean it like that.
I'm sure. You silly man. Come on, let's go find our seats.
How about here on the right?
Sure.
After you. All right. Well, shall we?
Yes. That was fun, Arthur.
It was.
All right. You better take me to the trolley now, Mr. Morgan.
Of course.
Quite ridiculous, but somehow very amusing.
Sure.
My life wasn't supposed to... Oh. Is it too late for us, Arthur?
I can't lie to you. I'm a wanted man, Mary. If anyone close to me, well, they're wanted too. And I can't have you wrapped up in there. But it's coming to an end. This time it really is.
Run away with me, Arthur. Run away right now and don't look back.
I want to. More than anything I want to. But I've got some people I need to take care of. Once they're free, then I'm free. Then I can disappear.
But Arthur...
If we're gonna run away anywhere, we'd need money. Soon, I'll have some.
I know you won't run away. But it's a pretty dream.
Very pretty. But I will, once I get some money. I had some, but then some fool got it trapped into a town that I can't go back to. That's another story.
I'll write you.
Yeah.
I know you.
Mr. Well, I believe we've met.
We have?
At that ghastly party.
Oh, Evelyn Miller.
Unfortunately so, Mr.
Arthur Morgan, at least sometimes.
Can I say something rude?
Sure.
The mayor thinks you robbed him. To be clear, he wasn't very upset about it. He rather liked you.
Okay.
Do you, Well, I mean to say, can you steal things?
Is there a reason you're asking me to incriminate myself, Mr. Miller?
Well, I'm sorry. Have you met? This is Rainsfall, a great chief, and his son, Eagle Flies.
Gentlemen, yeah, we saw you in the wagon train crossing the river at Cumberland Falls. And at the party, you were upstairs.
You have great powers of observation.
Yes, my people, if we... are even a people anymore. We've fought hard. We've made peace treaties, and those treaties were broken. And we've been moved and punished and punished and moved.
I'm sure.
And now I am told we are to be moved again.
Clearly contravening the peace treaty signed 3 years ago.
This will lead to war.
No, my son, it will not. We cannot fight another war. They have got stronger, and we have become far weaker, Mr. Morgan.
Well, it's a bad business.
It's to do with oil. I know it is, but I need the proof. I believe there were some prospectors who were on their land a few months ago who have filed reports with Leviticus Cornwall and the state government claiming huge reserves of oil under their land.
So, you want me to try and steal it?
Obviously, they can't. And even more obviously, I would be useless. Listen, I realize that it is a ridiculous request, but we're very desperate.
Now, I'm not a do-gooder, Mr. Miller. Gentlemen, I'm very sorry for your predicament, but I'm a working man. I got problems of my own.
We will pay you very handsomely, Mr. Morgan.
How much?
I told you, they're all mercenaries.
There's a price on my head in two states, my friend. The government doesn't like me any more than it does you. Like you, I've been running for as long as I can remember. And like you, my time here is nigh undone.
We understand, and we will pay.
Thank you.
You meet my son in a couple of days near Citadel Rock, just west of the oil fields.
Okay.
We are very grateful for your help.
Gentlemen, that appointment with the senator. We should head over there.
It's a waste of our time. And his. No.
We must try everything. Come along.
Hello, Mr. Miller. The counselor wants to apologize. He can see you now.
We've been waiting I don't know how long.
Or next month, if you'd like to reschedule.
Come. Perhaps the senator won't mind waiting.
Hey.
There. Oh, wonderful. Algernon Wasp, purveyor of the exotic and the exquisite. Enchanté.
Tacitus Kilgore.
How can I help you? May I interest you in a hat, perhaps? How about a nymph? I import them from Brussels. The idiots in this town all want Italian nymphs, but the Italians make the coarsest of marble. I mean, quite frankly, the Baroque is an abomination. Belgium. Now that is a land for the connoisseur.
Oh, yes. Yeah, as I always say. But, you know, I'm not really a nymph kind of man.
Oh, of course, too ephemeral. You want something, more tangible, more gothic. I also make corsets. Would you like a corset? I always wear one.
No, I don't think so. Yeah, I ride a lot of horses. The whalebone might stick in.
Well, a cup of tea.
Sure.
And what is it you do, Mr. Kilgore? Are you a gentleman of leisure? An aesthete? An artist.
I suppose I'm kind of an adventurer.
Ha! Huh. Yes, of course you are. Here, be careful with the china, sir. It is French.
Not Belgian?
No. They are Philistines in that area, not to be trusted. Youth, eternally preserved in marble, is more their specialty. I fear China will always elude them. Now, why are you here exactly?
I don't know.
You're an adventurer. A wanderer, a lost soul cast out from heaven?
Sure.
Well, I do pay exceptionally well for certain objects needed for my art.
You do?
I do. Exceptionally well.
Well, what do you need?
Let's see. Right now, I have a couple of commissions. I need at least 15 egret plumes. Good ones, obviously. I also need 15 assorted orchids. Here's a list.
Okay. I will see what I can do. Thanks for the tea.
Thank you, Tacitus. It'll be very worth your while.
They creep up on you, you know.
Huh? Mr. Morgan.
How are you?
Well, sir.
What are you working on?
Do you know anything about alligators?
Only the basics. Avoid them wherever possible.
Well, did you know that in the last 50 years, we've killed 90%?
You say that like it makes you sad.
They're beautiful creatures.
Let's see how you speak when one of them's got you in a death row.
Yes, I will make some creature a very happy lunch one of these days.
Let's try and avoid that from happening today, hmm? Well, you stay there, you'll get a great shot, then you'll get eaten.
What a way to go.
Why don't we take this boat out, and I'll protect you. Come on, get in the boat, he'll be fine.
Well, if you really think that's necessary.
You carry on shooting from that bank.
You're gonna wish them wolves had eaten you.
Really?
Yes. The 10% have survived. They're the nasty ones.
Just pull up to the bank.
That should do us.
Yes.
These pictures you're taking.
Yes.
They gonna be any good?
I certainly hope so. Though I doubt it. The subject is magnificent, the backdrop jaw-dropping, but the agent of beauty is a talentless fool. Although maybe I'll strike a few lucky shots.
You sure do make me laugh that way you talk about yourself, Mr. Mason.
Well, I'm good for laughing at, if nothing else.
I didn't mean it like that.
I know. Still, I feel such a fool round you, sir.
Don't worry about it. Oh.
I foresaw many an ignominious future for myself, but never damsel in distress.
Well, good luck, Mr. Mason.
Thank you, and to you too, sir.
Try and stay out of trouble.
I shall certainly try.
You came.
Of course I came. Said I would.
There's a foreman. His name is Danbury. Is the files in the office above the refinery room. It's that window with the blind drawn up.
I see it.
If the files are as incriminating as we believe, Mr. Cornwall's men will destroy them if they know you're coming.
There's only one of me, son. I don't intend for them to know I'm coming. What will the files say?
There'll be a report from Leyland Oil Development Company.
And you got the money?
Yes.
Any ideas how I sneak into this place?
You could crawl under the fence or hide in a wagon. They keep rolling in.
I'll go take a look.
If there's a problem, call for me.
I thought the whole point was that this had nothing to do with you.
Ideally.
Tom?
Picking up?
Yep. Supposed to meet the early train to Saint Denis.
Okay. Better get a move on then.
Oh, God. What do you want?
You must be Danbury.
What?
Hey, 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 hey! Hold it right there! Weapons on the ground and hands in the air.
Easy now, fellas.
Now! We won't tell you again.
I thought you wasn't getting involved.
Thought you were gonna enter and leave silently.
Thank you. You saved my life.
Thank you. I hope... Well, I don't know what I hope, but who knows? Maybe these will be of some use. Here's your money.
Thank you. Hello, Mary Beth.
Oh, how are you, Arthur?
Fine. How are you?
I'm well, I think. It's been quite a run we've had, but we're still alive.
So, no regrets?
Regrets for what?
Well, for joining this band of maniacs.
If you're a girl without means in this world, life is very scary. You boys care for me before no one cared for me. Well, life weren't very nice, Arthur. Not after Mama got typhoid, and that was a long time ago.
Sure.
What about you? I heard you ran into that Mary girl.
Yep.
And?
Got me thinking how that all ended. Long time ago now.
What happened?
Well, she didn't love me enough, I guess. Or I wouldn't change.
Huh. Well, she was a fool then, Arthur.
Well, she put a lot of good years in on an outlaw. She definitely was a fool.
In these books, life seems so simple, but in reality, I can't make head nor tail of it.
Mr. Morgan! Mr. Morgan, we have a problem. A real problem. It's Tilly.
What?
She's been taken by them Foreman brothers she used to run with. Come along!
The Foreman brothers? What are they doing here?
Well, I don't know what they've been doing here, but I can tell you what they're going to be doing here. Dying.
Sure. Do we need more guns?
You and I can handle this, Arthur.
Where are we heading?
I'll tell you on the way. Just get going.
It's okay, Miss Tilly. Now, let's get you out of here.
I thought there was...
Yeah, it don't matter what you thought. It's okay. All right, let's go.
Oh, come along, miss. Thank you, both of you.
What happened?
It was Anthony Foreman. He thinks he owns me.
I remember. Where is he?
He went out hunting or something. There were five of them, I think.
Well, we killed those fellas there.
There they are.
Come on.
Tilly, grab that gun. Anyone approaches, shoot them.
Oh, don't worry. I'll be just fine. Now catch that bastard. So he's still alive then?
I guess.
You see this girl? You leave her alone.
She killed my cousin.
Your goddamn cousin had it coming, Anthony Foreman.
I don't care if she shot your daddy and cooked your mama for breakfast. She's mine. She ain't yours.
You know, a friend of mine, he always says, revenge is a fool's game. Now, you want all your boys dead? She had her reasons.
We was family, Tilly Jackson.
You Foreman boys ain't no kind of family I want.
Kill him, Arthur!
You want that?
I want him to go away and tell the remaining of his cousins and the clowns he rides with to leave me alone!
Now, you think you can do that, Anthony? Or should I slit your throat and just save us all the bother?
I'll leave you alone. History is done.
History is never done. It's your call, Arthur. But I'd slit his throat.
Go on. Finish the bastard off.
All right, you.
Come on. Let's get you home.
Now get out of here. What you fools up to?
It's Mr. Black's fault.
His fault, the darky white. Although I don't know why they call him that. Look at him.
Don't you start now.
I'll knock the color clean off you. Come on.
And I'll tell you, you lily livered.
Enough. You two fools look like you've just run off a chain gang.
Yeah, what of it?
What are you doing?
Starving.
They got bounty posters for us all over town.
And we can't go into town to get supplies.
Say, mister, maybe you can do us fools a favor. We ain't bad guys at all. He's okay, even for a darkie.
Shut up, you pasty-faced streak of piss!
Yeah, I had up to here with you.
Enough! Do your goddamn favor what you want.
Maybe you can go into town and take down them wanted posters of us.
Okay.
Maybe meet us back at the campfire in the woods and tell us how you did.
Maybe bring us a little bite to eat.
Don't push your luck.
Nice fella.
Yeah, you love nice fellas. Hey, friend.
Hello.
I was in town.
Pretty hot. There's quite a price on you boys.
It is so unfair. I didn't do nothing.
Well, they said you was wanted for murder.
It wasn't murder. It was self-defense.
And you killed a farmer?
Well, firstly, I would have, but he died before I could. And secondly, well, he had it coming. I don't like to say.
Well, ain't no business of mine. Here's the posters.
Thanks, partner.
How you doing, Mrs. Adler?
How are you? Been quite a journey since I joined you fellas.
Yes.
And now you and Dutch have joined high society. Oh, Lord above.
Yeah, it seems so.
I think my days in polite society are over.
Well,
I just saw Bill Williamson at a party at the San Denise's mayor's house. If he can do it, anyone can.
You get any leads?
Yeah, I think so.
You know so, Arthur Morgan. Come on, we need to talk. Miss Adler, will you excuse us?
When are you gonna let me come robbing with you, Dutch?
My lord, a few more like her, we could take over the whole world.
A few more like her, there wouldn't be much of a world left.
Yes, perhaps.
Now, the trolley bus station. I went down there. I took a look at it.
I think we can hit it.
I ain't never robbed in a city before.
Well, you leave the planning to me. You'll ride with me.
Always. Is it just you and me?
No, we'll need one more, I reckon.
I say Lenny.
Not Micah.
Well, that depends if you want a massacre or a payday.
No, I wish that there was something I could do to make the two of you get along better.
Well, that's easy. Make him change.
Very funny. What is that?
What the hell have they done to me?
Look, there in the tree line.
Everybody take cover! The Disco Boys are coming!
Arthur Knapp, go on! You...
Get those doors barricaded quick!
Good! Now, everyone, I got this. Get these windows covered quickly. John, you take the windows over there. Charles, you take the side door there. Arthur, you take the windows in the back. Go!
We okay?
I think so. Except for Karen here. Poor kid. Mr. Swanson, would you take this boy and bury him someplace near, but not too near?
Of course. Charles, help me with the body.
We need to get this place cleaned up. Mr. Pearson, Miss Grimshaw.
Already taking care of it. Come on now, work.
Colm O'Driscoll.
That man can really hate.
So can I, Arthur. So can I. We need to get moving. Away from here.
So we should start looking for another camp.
You ain't thinking big enough, Arthur. You ain't seeing the vastness of our problems and our opportunities.
I'm not sure I get you.
You will, son. You will. Meet me near the trolley station. We got work.
Shall we?
Yep.
He saved my life, and I could not save his. Mrs. Adler fought braver than any of us. She is driven by powerful forces I scarcely understand. That's what love has done to her, I guess.
Ah, there you are, dear boy.
Yes, here I am.
Well, we're going to need to get you smartened up a bit.
Why?
Well, you can't play at the tables on a Lanahassee riverboat looking like this.
You can't?
Not if you want to fit in so well that no one will realize you're there to rob the place. Now, come on.
Are we still doing that?
George, to the Grand Corrigan, please.
Grand Corrigan, sir.
Well, look at you. From Toad to Prince.
Yeah, this is a bit much, ain't it? The coach?
We can't whinny up there on horses like a bunch of countrified yokels. You're a brash oil man. Money to burn. Which reminds me, no shuffling and mumbling. Puff your chest out. Get outside yourself.
Yeah, all right, all right. St. Hamlet. So, who's a mark?
Are you all right, by the way, the driver?
Oh, yes. Don't worry. George and I go way back. It's a man called Desmond Blythe. Made a fortune in hosiery of all things. Likes to play fast and always keep some extra collateral in the safe upstairs.
So, if Strauss is sitting behind him, how does he know what cards I got?
He won't. but the dealer has recently become a very good friend of mine.
Another one.
Don't worry, Arthur. We're all the authors of our own good fortune. He'll make sure you get the right cards.
What could possibly go wrong?
Indeed.
And what money am I playing with?
Don't worry. That has all been arranged. Your chips will be waiting. Ah, there she is. Come on.
Okay.
Arthur, leave any weaponry here. They'll search us when we get on. George, we'll collect these from you later.
Very good, sir.
Thank you, George.
Good luck, sir. I'm afraid we require all patrons to hand over their guns.
Good time. The tables await.
I'll go find myself a change of clothes.
Okay.
You seem unsure.
Robbing a heavily armed riverboat without a gun tends to bring out the self-doubt in me.
These people are virtually idiots. This is simple stuff. Now have a good time, but don't lose too much money or your wife is going to kill me.
Whatever you say. Good evening, gentlemen. Arthur Callahan. Sorry I'm late. I had some unfinished business at the bar.
Evening. Desmond Blythe.
Evening.
Not to worry. Welcome to the game, Mr. Callahan. Okay, gentlemen, let's play.
I hope you're a player. Been too many cowards at these tables recently. Nothing less dignified than a man afraid to lose a little money.
Mr. Blythe wins with three queens.
Goodbye, gentlemen. I guess it's just you and me now, friend.
Yes, it is.
Time to see if you're really the man you seem to think you are.
Likewise, Mr. Blythe.
Ship! Ship!
I guess my luck held. Is that you done?
Done?
Bust. Or, you got something else to play with?
Meaning?
Well, I heard there were some big boys on this boat. Maybe that's not you. No offense.
Sit your hillbilly ass down.
Why?
I got a watch.
Look at you.
An expensive one. Real fine. Swiss. A Reutlinger, no less. It's in the safe upstairs. It's worth more than you.
Okay. I trust you.
Now play.
As you wish. Yes, you little beauty.
Hard lines, Mr. Blythe. Mr. Callahan wins with an ace-high diamond flush.
God damn you! No offense.
None taken.
Well played, sir.
Unlucky, Desmond.
Now, forgive my lack of discretion, but where might I find this watch?
It's upstairs. Shall we go and have a look?
Why not?
Gentlemen. There he is.
Now, don't be a sore loser, friend.
There's something I don't like about the pair of you.
There's plenty I don't like about you, but I have the good manners to keep my mouth shut.
There he is. Shoot that man.
Come on, Arthur. We gotta get out of here. Oh, my God.
Well, never a dull moment.
Yeah, that's one way of putting it.
So, how much did we get?
A few thousand, I think. Pretty good.
Yes, indeed.
And this watch, apparently it's worth a bunch. Swiss, a Reutlinger or something?
Nice watch. Yes, it's a Reutlinger, all right.
We'll give it back then. All right, come on, let's get out of here.
Yeah? What do you want?
Do I look like a coward to you? I mean, obviously I do, because I look like that milksop there, but 'tis no matter. Can you help?
Maybe.
See, Even he is sick of hearing your nonsense, you afterthought of a child. I apologize, sir, for his smell. Why don't we come back here? To somewhere more conducive to displays of utter gallantry and deep-seated inadequacy.
Well, what did you have in mind?
Shoot a bottle off my head, like William Tell.
This is getting silly.
Very silly. The man is a moron. Shoot one off mine instead. I'm the brave one.
I'm not scared.
I'm a good shot, but...
I won't even flinch.
I don't want to hurt you, boys.
Oh, I can't lose. Either I'll prove my masculinity or die and be spared his company. Come, sir, please.
Okay, then. Listen, just make sure everyone knows you asked me to do this.
Of course, of course, of course.
You boys are ridiculous.
Kate.
That was fun.
What was? I feel like we didn't even do anything.
Oh, of course you didn't. We all know you're hardly sentient at all.
Another round, smaller bottles, sir. Please.
What?
I don't know.
Please, this creature is unbearable. He needs silencing.
I'll do my best. As long as she witnesses that I'm doing this under duress.
Oh, you boys are so silly.
Now I'll stand on one leg.
Me too. You keep shooting, sir, and this time you kill the beast. He emerged fully formed from the swamps, Helen.
Silence, you blackguard. Sir, shoot the wretch.
Ready?
Whew. Now do one while I hop.
Do one while I turn somersaults. Shoot me.
Oh, give me the gun. Let me shoot him. For all mankind.
I think me and the lady have had enough.
I don't blame you, sir. This man's tongue, I would run too if I could. Here, for your skills and talents.
Thank you.
Now, brother, I am going to walk Helen home. Don't follow us. She has an elderly aunt, and I fear the sight of you could finally finish her off.
Helen, is this creep bothering you?
You two, come along.
Oh, no, there aren't two. There's me and the lizard man. Please, my angel, do not aggregate us both together.
Boy, you are too much.
Nope, my sweet.
Oh, my friend with no name. You found us.
Sure.
How did you get on?
About how you'd expect.
Well, any good anecdotes?
Anecdotes?
From the old days.
To be honest, things went a little differently. I did shoot a lot of people. I thought that's sort of what you wanted.
Well, I'd, yes, that'll be fine. Do you think anyone noticed it was you?
Noticed? I think the people I shot noticed.
I mean, do you think anyone would mind if I, if we said he'd done it? Boy Calloway.
Sure, I don't care. Just as long as...
Share the money? Of course I will. Literature is a filthy business, but sometimes it pays well. Especially when you lie.
Great.
Not so goddamn fast! What the hell's going on here?
Nothing.
Who's this Grassney?
You know? I don't know.
Have you been being me?
I'm nobody, buddy.
Well, I'm somebody! And I can't have any nobody being this somebody, you goddamn... I don't know what the goddamn you are, but trust me, it ain't nothing I want to be, so you can't be me.
What a way with words.
Oh, damn you, Theodore Levin. You're a snake. Damn you. Hey, damn you, nobody.
Hey, I'm already damned.
Oh, but I can't take credit for that, which I... Damn says I didn't. I'm an old man. This never happened to Achilles, to Gawain, to Caesar. It can't happen to me. I will kill both of you!
Yeah, calm down.
I'm a legend!
Yes, you are!
All right, well, let's prove it one more time.
I don't have to prove nothing to you, nobody.
No, of course you don't, but maybe you need to prove something to you.
You got quite a way with words. Maybe you should write my book and we should kill Plato here!
Let's not. Now, come on. Who shall we kill? You kill, I mean.
Ah, damn. I slayed my dragons years ago. I'm a tired old man.
Now, you're drunk and you're bored and you're a mess.
Well, I always hated Slim Grant. He killed my cousin. But that was years ago.
Well, where's Slim Grant? Who's Slim Grant?
This is him. An old friend of Mr. Calloway's.
He ain't no friend of mine.
He's state marshal now, out of Annisburg.
State marshal? Make a damn cousin killer state marshal, do they?
All right, I'll go get him.
Great. We'll wait for you at Brandywine Drop.
Just sober up and start practicing. Otherwise, this won't be a book. It'll be a memorial.
Whatever you say. You know what? I kind of like that fella.
You. I'm looking for Slim Grant, state marshal. Heard you boys know where to find him.
Oh, Mr. Marshall was here last week. I think he headed up to Beaver Hollow looking for some outlaws.
Is he coming back?
Sure, when he catches them fellers he's been after.
Well, how long's he been gone?
Well, a couple of days.
Well, you ain't gonna go look for him?
If your boss's boss, who you all hated, went missing, possibly dead, at the hands of a bunch of violent wanted men, would you go looking for him?
Well, yeah, probably, because I'm a fool.
Well, when he's dead, maybe I'll become marshal. I'll be a hero riding a horse from town to town, mister. Think of that.
Good luck with those dreams.
There!
I think so.
Did you kill his cousin back in 82?
Whose cousin?
My cousin.
I never shot no one, didn't deserve it.
You shot Jed Calloway.
And I told you then I'd shoot you, too. And I would've, if you'd shown up.
I was there.
No, you weren't. You left town.
You take that back.
But I don't care now. It's nigh on 20 years ago. We're old men. We're lucky.
Fight me.
You're an old man.
Come on, fight me.
It's a bit late, isn't it?
God damn you!
Well, that settles that, then.
I shot him back. I shot him in the goddamn back.
When these things happen.
God damn you, goddamn both of you!
Well, now calm down. Who cares? You should have shot him 20 years ago. He's dead now.
You are a sickness scum like you and you, Plato. Come on, draw!
Why?
I said draw, goddammit!
No.
Yes!
Shit, indeed. Still, at least now you got an ending to your book.
He's dead.
Oh, don't you start now.
No, I'm not starting. I'm happy. I'm free. I can finally go back to writing westerns instead of being in one.
Yeah, he was pretty wild. And I know some wild people.
He was certainly complicated.
I'm sorry I shot him.
No. And you didn't shoot him. He did. In the back. After he mortally wounded Slim Grant. Fair and square.
Yes, that's it.
Last of the gunslingers.
Well, more or less, I guess.
There's more?
Oh, well, there's always folk who shoot you in the back and then rewrite history.
Well, hey, where do I send the money?
Send it to Tacitus Kilgore. No, that ain't my real name.
There you are. Come on, keep walking. You're late.
A couple of days in this place, you turned into some clock-watching city boy. What's the urgency?
We need to leave. Forever. We've been doing well, making money. But for us all to leave together, we need enough for a boat. Now, I found a friendly ship captain. He's willing to take us to Australia or Tahiti. We just need to pay for passage and give him money for land when we get there. No questions asked. We will disappear, be reborn.
Well, where the hell is Tahiti?
South Pacific, an untouched paradise.
Who lives there?
Tahitians, I guess.
We made a bit of money on that riverboat job, but not enough for us to leave and live peacefully. Where's the rest coming from?
In there.
So we are gonna rob that place?
Well, I didn't think we was fixing the plumbing. I don't know if you have noticed, but we are on the clock. I reckon we got a few days before the Pinkertons show, and then, well, we're done. Now, we need money. Bronte said this place has got money. Come on. Ladies and gentlemen, this is a robbery. Behave as I tell you, and none of you will die.
There's almost nothing here.
There should be stacks of cash in there. He told us there was. Look again.
There's no stacks. A few dollars in coins. That's it.
Damn! We got a problem. There's a ton of cops out there.
Come on now! We got you surrounded!
That greasy son of a bitch! He set us up!
You think?
This seemed like a good time for sarcasm to you, Arthur.
What are we gonna do, gentlemen?
Something! The trolley. The trolley! Follow me, gentlemen! Go! Woo-hoo! Now!
Whoa! Does this trolley go to Tahiti?
I hope so. Arthur, slow. Slow this thing down!
I'll try. The thing's broke. Hold on!
I think we're clear.
You know what, Dutch? Next time, it's not damn discretion.
Seemed like a good lead.
I know, but...
Well, we made it. Thanks to you.
Don't mention it.
Yeah.
You're a good kid.
And we each got $15. Oh, and a quarter. Don't forget the quarter.
Shut up, Arthur. He set us up. Played me like a yokel. Put the law on us. What did we do to him? What did I do to him?
I guess he thinks he's the king around here. He don't want the likes of you. So, what are we doing next, Dutch?
We just need money. One more decent take, and we're gone. The bank is our bet. Hosea agrees.
Even after that?
Especially after that. I don't feel so good.
Now you just got a bash on the head.
Come on. I'm taking you back to camp.
Hey, you did real good there, Lenny. Just wish it could have turned out better.
Well, can't win them all.
Hey, mister. Oh, hey, friend.
You boys don't look so fresh.
We ain't.
I think we're dying, friend.
We ate some bad mushrooms.
Bad business, sure.
It's been real tough, partner.
So it seems.
I hate to ask, but we need some medicine. Kind of fast.
Medicine?
Yeah, look at us. Look at me. And he's worse than he looks.
Oh.
And he looks like shit. He ain't gonna last 3 days. And me? I ain't well. Not at all.
Not at all.
I'm begging you, partner. Why? I told you you'd help us. I told you, did I?
You did. You told me. You told me a lot of things.
We're gonna be all right, buddy.
Are we?
Well, physically. Drink this.
I'll give it to Black first.
No. Don't give it to White.
No.
Drink this and
take
shut
it
up.
Thank you.
Oh, that's good stuff.
Ooh. But listen, I reckon you boys should get on out of here. Maybe split up. Head up north or overseas. They don't like groups of men. I know.
I hear you, boss.
So, Arthur, you get the deciding vote.
About what? We take an insult and scurry off like cockroaches? but deal with business the right way.
We don't need to take revenge. We hardly know the guy.
This ain't about revenge, Hosea. Angelo Bronte don't mean shit to me. This is about the fact we are planning to rob a bank in his town. A bank that he no doubt protects. A town where his men are gunning for us. Before we do that, we need to put him out of commission.
I disagree. There's always an easier way.
There ain't no easier way. Now, I know his type. He is a vindictive little power broker who rules by fear. Now, we pull that stunt in his cesspit of a town, we're doomed. You want to leave this place? Leave this country? We need that money.
I just don't feel good, Dutch.
This is it. This is the last job that we are ever going to pull. Before the year is out, we are going to be harvesting mangoes in Tahiti. Farmers. But we need seed capital, and we need to leave. You know it. I know it.
Forgive me if I can't think too much about the mango harvest.
This is it. Trust me. Arthur.
If it's business, well, business is business.
Angelo Bronte stands between us and our future.
You'll damn us all.
Arthur, come on.
You better be right about this one.
I am. Thomas, it is good to see you, my friend.
Hello, Mr. Dutch.
Thomas, have you met Arthur? Arthur, Thomas is quite the boatman. He's gonna help us get close to our prey. The other night we had quite the adventure fishing for catfish. Now, my friend, can I call in that favor?
What do you need?
You know Angelo Bronte. Well, exactly. We need to make a social call. We were hoping you could row us in quietly one evening around the back of his house.
Well, if anyone can, I can.
We'll pay you for your trouble.
If you're bringing him trouble, it won't be no trouble for me.
Good.
My business partner, Jules, he's out on the skiff. I need to check with him. Plus, I need to check the traps. Would you come with me?
Of course. Arthur?
Why not?
Shouldn't take too long if we can find him.
I got the skiff! It's over here! Good. Stuck!
I got it loose. Jump.
Good man.
All right, let's get back to the dock.
Yes, please, let's go.
Oh, your boy doesn't look too good there.
Here, take this. Try to stop the bleeding.
You're gonna be okay, son.
Okay! I think it's had enough!
Now, Jesus, can we get back now? You're gonna be okay, kid.
Sorry, Jules. Guess all them stories was true. Big and bad. That's unusual. Normally, the little one's angry. Big ones is lazy.
Well, I guess he never outgrew his anger. Kind of reminds me of you, Arthur.
You know, I don't think I've ever seen you squeal before, Dutch.
I weren't the one squeal.
Yeah, well, you weren't in the water with him. And this poor boy was nearly dinner.
Can we get some help? Jules has been bitten.
Oh, my God.
There's a monster out here. He's been bitten, but he's alive. Just keep him warm. Feed him garlic for the infection. Thank you. Both of you. I'm at your service anytime you need. Oh,
thank you, Thomas. Where can we find you?
You just meet me back here.
Very good.
Can one of you help me put the boat back out?
Sure. I'm gonna head back to camp and placate the irritable Miss O'Shea, who's causing more trouble. I'll collect the boys. Meet you back here, Arthur.
Mr. Arthur? Old Bronte. A bad man.
I know.
Killed some good folks. Hurt a lot of people.
Well, he definitely lacks a certain charm. I'll see you soon.
You be safe. We got monsters out here.
Well.
Mr. Mason!
Oh! Oh! Mr. Morgan!
You want to be careful up here. Land is real treacherous.
Sure.
Real treacherous. I've been here before.
Have you?
Yes. Funny how things turn out. Never quite how you expect, is it?
No, I don't suppose it is.
What you shooting?
Eagles. You know, the images, they really are beautiful. All thanks to you. I'd be some poor creature's bad meal by now, many times over, but for you.
Oh, that's my pleasure. Please, you step away from the cliff edge.
But I'm trying to get an eagle there.
Yeah, they're beautiful. But unlike you, they can fly.
Too true. You really must think I'm a buffoon, don't you? You think I'm such a dimwit, I'd just slip off the edge of a cliff.
No, but, well, maybe a little.
Please, sir. I'm dense, but not that dense. This area is quite safe. Quite. Oh, oh!
Ah! Damn!
You're right. I am that much of a buffoon. Give me a hand, please. Put me out of my misery.
Come here.
Oh, dear. Oh, thank you. You know what? Bugger the eagles, I'm going home. You know, I really did get some amazing pictures, thanks to you. And somehow, I haven't quite broken my neck.
You take care.
And you too, sir. Sorry for all the trouble.
Still working, Mr. Strauss. What you been up to?
Trying to wrap up our accounts before we leave, Mr. Morgan.
So you'll be joining us in Tahiti?
I rather fancied Australia. A similar kind of people to us. Lots of opportunity.
Dutch tells me we're going to be ranchers.
Perhaps, but so far we have not raised many cattle.
No.
So, Mr. Morgan, will you help me finalize our business here?
This is filthy work.
We'll need money in Australia. For cattle and feed, I mean. Why flinch now? You never have done before.
I don't know.
Well, here they are. Some fishermen by the name of Davison, Algie Davison, living in a place called Catfish Jackson near Scarlet Meadows.
A fisherman.
And that's it. We're a union built on debt, you know.
Okay.
Arthur, there you are. Come on. Thomas, let's get going.
Right you are.
Hey, Bill, you were a sharpshooter in the cavalry, weren't you?
What?
When we get there, maybe you could help with the suppression fire.
I never said I was no sharpshooter.
Oh, that's right. What was it? The nation's most loyal latrine digger, wasn't that it?
Yeah, well, I fought, and I fought well.
So you always tell us.
You taught me something you could do with learning. Them Indians were savages.
Watch your mouth there, boy. Watch it. Only type of savage in these parts are moonshine, swilling, pompous, inbred locals.
Dutch, I saw things out there.
I don't doubt you saw things, Bill, but your tiny little mind was too small to comprehend what you saw. What you saw was people who lost everything to savagery. Savagery of peasants. Failures come from Europe to reap some awful vengeance on God's last creation.
Interesting way you boys gotta prepare for a killing.
I'm sorry I wasted my life trying to teach you boys.
Love you though, I do.
Well, leaving love aside, you think we got this?
Don't you never leave love aside, Arthur. It's all we got. Now you pick us up yonder.
I got you.
Thank you.
Good luck to you.
Okay. I'm sorry, friend. No, name your price. Name your price. Every man have a price. Okay. No, I surrender.
Put him in front. Bill, you help.
Got him?
Oh, come on, Lenny.
All right, come on. Let's get out of here.
Yep.
Oh, hey, big man. We gonna ransom you or what?
You're pathetic.
Well, I am. Because from where I'm sitting, you're the one deserving of pity, my friend. All your men, all your money, it weren't no match for a bunch of bumpkins.
You are nothing. You do nothing, you mean nothing, you stand for nothing. Me, I run a city. And when the law catch up to you, you will die like nothing. I am this country. You are what people are running from.
I possess things that you will never understand.
You don't even possess your own men. $1,000 to the man who kills him and sets me free.
What are you gonna say now?
They are even bigger fools than you.
No doubt.
The law will find you. Already, the dogs are on the way.
Oh, yeah. Oh, you're right. You are so right.
They are good at smelling filth, huh? So filth has got to be disposed of. Your friends of Pinkerton's gonna come and rescue you, you repulsive little maggot. Call them now. You call them.
Jesus.
Part of your philosophy books cover feeding a fellow the goddamn alligator, Dutch.
The part that covers weakness. That part.
I don't know.
Well, I do. It ain't nice. I know it, but it is us or him. I figure it might as well be him.
Jim?
Look, the bank, Karen, Tilly, Abigail, I sent them all. They all say the same thing. There's no more than one armed guard. And the police? It's a city, there are police, but as far as we can tell, the patrols will all be going this way when Abigail and I cause the diversion. That's the opportunity.
What do you think, Arthur?
I don't see we have a lot of choice. We linger around here, we know we're dead.
But the plan?
We got a decent bunch. We know how to fight. The city cops don't seem so tough, as long as we move fast. I reckon doing it in the day with a distraction. If that's what Jose is saying, it's as good a plan as any.
I think I agree.
We do it at night. There's the dram of just getting into the bank. Can't do that silently. They'll pick us off far easier.
I know. I'm just making sure.
Every plan is a good plan if we execute it properly. Every problem we had was because we did not execute properly. Even Blackwater, from my understanding.
You're right. Let's rob this bastard. Everyone get some rest. We ride out in the morning. Look smart. Travel light.
You got everything, Arthur?
Sure.
So, we rob ourselves a bank, and within 6 weeks, we're living life anew in a tropical idyll, spending the last of our days as banana farmers. Let's get out of this godforsaken place and go rob ourselves a bank!
Think we got a problem out here!
Come out! It's over!
Shit! Abigail!
Dutch! Get out here! Get out here now!
Someone must have squealed.
Never should have gone after Bronte, Dutch.
Mr. Milton? Let my friend go! Or folks, they are gonna get shot unnecessarily!
Your friend? Why would I do that?
Come on, Milton!
It's over! No more bargains, no more deals.
Mr. Milton, this is America. You can always cut a deal.
I've given you enough chances.
Come on! Don't!
No!
God damn it! There's your deal, Dutch.
Who's there?
Arthur!
We lost John.
Killed?
Arrested. I couldn't help.
Well, we better go. We'll be next.
What you think?
I reckon me and Lenny try and find a way across the roof,
if you'll cover us.
Sure, sure. Go on! I don't believe it.
They knew we were coming. Just like your ferry job in Blackwater.
Ain't nothing like that. What now?
I don't know. I don't. This whole town is filled with cops.
Well, how long are we gonna stay here? A few hours?
We go back to camp? They're gonna get every last one of us. I know they're gonna be watching the roads. I got it. A boat.
What you mean?
We stay here till nightfall. Then we sneak on down to the docks. We get ourselves out of here.
Yeah, where?
Any place will do. That's all I got. We leave. We lie low. We come back for the rest in a few weeks.
I'm guessing it's that. We die out there right now.
Exactly. Now, everybody, calm down. I mean, look at us. Okay, follow me, and keep your heads down.
What now?
Well, at least we got some gold.
I'm sure. This boat ain't going to Tahiti by any chance.
I don't know. John.
Lenny.
Jose. That wasn't good.
I know. So what are we gonna do now?
Guess I'm gonna introduce myself to the captain. Give him some of this gold to secure his silence.
And find out where we're heading.
How do I look?
Like a shifty, no good killer on the run from the law.
Ain't that the truth? Excuse me, sir.
Hey, who are you?
Forgive me. A stowaway. Can I see the captain, please? I come in peace. Well, it's gonna take a little more gold, but I think we're gonna be okay. This captain, he is a fine fella, a New Englander from the Cape. The rest of the ship is Frenchmen. They're heading down to the islands, taking some Pennsylvania coal. Now, apparently, we're gonna be able to slip ashore in northern Cuba in a couple of days.
That's so.
Apparently.
What are we gonna do in Cuba, Dutch?
Hold up for a while, then hurry back, gather up the rest of our family. At least we got some money now. Money and loyalty. With that, you can do whatever you please.
So you reckon they'll follow us to Cuba?
Like Colonel Waxman on a jolly? I highly doubt it. I reckon we hold ourselves to ourselves, and this is done and dusted.
Let's hope so.
I ain't no sailor, but, that cloud looked like good news to you.
Wake up! Everybody! Wake up! Wake up!
Come on, Arthur!
Wake up!
I don't know, but we are getting off of this boat. You come on!
Would you get a move on, you sleepy bastard?
Please, Laura, hey, I'll be right behind you. Jesus.
Dance!
Dance!
I'm okay. You?
Yeah.
This ain't moving.
Yeah, you go on ahead. I'll try and find another way.
Oh, God damn it!
Boys.
You're alive. Arthur.
No puede ser.
You're You're alive!
Arthur,
you're
okay.
It is a miracle. It is a goddamn miracle. Here, have something to drink. Have a drink. Somebody give him a goddamn drink! Oh, son. Son, take it easy. We got you. We got you.
So, where the hell are we?
We are on the island of Guarm. Javier asked a local. It's a old sugar plantation island. Second island east of Cuba.
Is it anywhere near Australia or Tahiti?
It's on the way, I guess.
So, what next?
I don't know. Well, next I guess we're gonna get shot.
Encadenen a estos hombres!
Gentlemen, this is quite a welcome.
Who are you?
Senor, por favor, we are no one.
What's your name?
Aiden O'Malley.
Is that so? What are you doing, Mr. O'Malley?
Surviving. We were lost at sea. In the storm.
Is that so?
No. I'm in the habit of looking like this. Is all of this really necessary?
We got enough troubles around here right now, Mr. O'Malley, without taking a chance on a bunch of vagabonds. Behave yourselves and no harm will befall you.
Vamos!
Vamos! Vamos! Muévanse!
You and me both. Who are these people?
Who knows?
Well, they got them chained and lashed, but they don't look too dangerous.
Excuse me, sir. Who are our new friends here?
Criminales.
What crime did they commit?
Insurrection.
Insurrection? That's quite a word.
Cállate, señor Fuentes. Muévanse. Todos.
Everyone okay?
Yeah.
Damn. Reinforcements.
Mon Dieu. We need to get out of here.
Now we're in trouble.
Come on, Fevit. Everyone, follow me. Vite, Fevit. Come.
Javier!
Get out of here. Get out of here. There's a lot of them.
What do you think?
We gotta move, Dutch.
Don't lose face, son. We'll find you.
Cui. Go!
Come on, Arthur!
Quickly! I have some guns stashed here. Come! Come on, follow me. Quick! What are you doing here?
I have no idea. Running from somebody or something, I guess.
How went we all? Hercule Fontaine.
Dutch Vanderlyn. These drowned rats are Micah, Bill, and Arthur.
Okay. Well, Fusa will be desperate to find you. We must be very careful.
So, who is this Fusar?
A tyrant.
driven by nothing but power and greed. Our only purpose is to work ourselves to death to make him rich.
Leon wants the people to stand up to Fusa, but most are too afraid.
And you?
I am not from here. I bring things in and off the islands behind Colonel Fusa's back. Let's rest a moment. Down there is Aqua Dolce, Fusa's compound. The sugarcane these poor men kill themselves farming gets processed in that factory there.
They're little more than slaves shipped in from other islands. A group escaped yesterday into the jungle, hoping to find a way back to their homes.
Now Fusa's men are out hunting them down. That old fort? Cinco Torres. My men and I use that as a hideout when we are here. Come on. I know somewhere you men can rest.
Can we trust you?
I don't see you have any choice. I am the only one who can arrange a boat for you. But I need something in return. Help Leon with that group of escape workers, and then come meet me at the fort.
If you help us get back our friend and get out of here,
we will do everything we can.
Thank you.
Gracias.
If your friend is still alive, they will have him at Fusa's compound. There is a cave hidden below the cliffs. It will lead you right there.
Thank you.
The workers are somewhere in the jungle. Hopefully we can get to them before Fusa does.
Of course.
Gentlemen.
Well?
Goodbye.
If this is a tropical paradise, so far it ain't up to much.
I'll go scope the entrance to that cave. Arthur.
I need to get some rest.
Well, you're right. We all need to relax. What a mess. I'm so sorry, boys.
Get some sleep, Dutch.
Micah, guard this spot. Bill, do some more scouting. Carefully.
¿Quién es este hombre?
No lo había visto antes. Me estaba siguiendo en el bosque. ¡Un tipo raro!
Still time to get to the other workers.
I think I hear voices coming from the other ruins down there. Let's sneak down and take a look.
Which way?
I'll show you. Baptiste, you don't look good. You should rest here.
Okay. You'll need this. Go! Go!
Come, follow me.
That looks like the last of them.
Vengan, hermanos. Estarán bien. Este gringo valiente le salvó la vida.
Thank you, my friend. I'm Baptiste. I work with Hercule. We owe you our lives.
Yes. Thank you.
My pleasure. This place makes me miss home.
Take care, my friend.
Hercules getting a boat lined up to get you and your men out of here. Just meet him at Cinco Torres.
We'll be there.
Good, good. Here, this is for you.
Thanks.
It's not much, but it's the least we can do. Good luck getting home.
Hey. So, what's the plan?
Well, I found the cave Hercule spoke of, and also a guide. She's up ahead. I think we can trust her.
Follow me. The entrance is along here. Just watch your footing.
So, what do we do when we get Javier back?
Well, gonna get the hell out of here. And set sail for the one place. Ain't nobody gonna be expecting us. Get everybody together. And get ourselves back on course.
Where would that be?
Place we just escaped from.
You wanna go back to Saint-Denis?
If it was you got left, you'd want us to go back.
I'd want it, but I wouldn't expect it.
That's the point. Ain't no one gonna expect it. We come back from the dead, gather everyone, and we leave before anyone realizes we've even resurrected.
An insect bite you or something? Cause you gone, friend.
We look like what we are. A bunch of desperados on the run. But with the women, a change of clothes? We're a choir, or a gang of pilgrims, or something.
Whatever you say. A bunch of penniless fugitives on some Caribbean dump, sneaking through caves while two of our best men got shot back home. How could I doubt you, Dutch?
You got no idea, Arthur. No idea at all. I will do whatever it takes for us to survive.
I guess that's what I'm afraid of.
Hold on.
Why?
Gloria!
Ay, estás tarde.
Buenas noches.
Buenas noches. Dinero, the money, the gold.
Aquí.
Dámelo.
Oh, it's genuine, you old hag.
Ay. Vamos. Vamos. Rápido.
Now that gold right there, that's the last bit of gold I have in my pocket from the bank. The rest of it is
at the bottom of the sea.
Exactly.
What was that?
Horrible old crone.
But you killed her.
She was gonna betray us, Arthur. Couldn't you tell?
No.
Well, I got some Spanish. She was.
You keep killing folk, Dutch.
I am just trying to make sure that some of us survive, Arthur. Now, shall we proceed?
I guess.
Listen, son, you think I want any of this?
I don't know.
Of course I don't. But I made a pledge to you all. We would survive, no matter what.
So how did you know she was gonna betray us? What'd she say?
It was in her eyes, in the way she was leading us.
But you said you knew Spanish.
I know human beings, Arthur.
Are you gonna strangle me next?
I'm doing the best I can.
But my friend! I do not understand. Who are you?
I come from Mexico. I never met those men.
Does anyone believe him? Mr. Simon doesn't believe you. Even the mule doesn't believe you.
Eso no fue para tanto. Así que deja de actuar. Sabemos que no estuvo tan fuerte.
Fue bastante duro.
No, la próxima vez será aún más duro. Bueno, ha sido un placer.
Siempre me encantaron. Los mexicanos.
Ah,
for this.
We did what you asked.
It's like I said. Fusar knows who you are and knows the price on your head. It's a big problem.
I see.
But if we can silence him, then I can help you escape before anyone has time to get here from America. That way, we all get what we want.
We want to get the boat you promised us.
And you will. But you have found yourself in the middle of a war, I'm afraid. Fusar has called in the Navy from Cuba. There's no way a boat could leave right now.
Hercule! Hercule, s'il vous plaît! Vite! Vite!
Come. Follow me.
Oui. So I guess great minds think alike.
So what now?
Hurry, Arthur! We need that cannon!
Damn! This is heavy!
Damn! There's a whole lot more of them turning up!
This don't look good, fellas!
Oh, damn it!
Let's go down and clear them off the beach!
Wait! I'll come too!
And me!
We'll guard this thing!
Come on!
Bert! You made the cannon! I'll get you some more shot. Empty water line. We need to put a serious hole in that boat.
There we go!
Yes! They're going down! Let's get down from here. Come on.
That was quite some shooting, boys.
Thank you.
What now?
Oh, they'll be back. But I found a boat for you. And he should be arriving on the dock anytime now.
Great. Micah, go meet with the captain. If he's amenable and discreet, tell him we'll be ready to set sail soon. Bill, come help me collect poor old Javier.
Sure. And
cool. It was a great pleasure to make your acquaintance.
I thought I was dead for sure.
Hi, boys. We got a real problem. Nice Mr. Fusar don't want us going nowhere. He knows just who we are. If he can keep us here for a few more days, well...
And what about the captain of the ship here?
They got him trussed up like a hog. Guards all over the place. Got us surrounded with gun positions, so when we try to sail out, he's gonna blow holes in us.
This fella is really beginning to try my patience.
He ain't even had you tortured yet.
I like the man's style. He's thorough, nasty, and vindictive. However... In this instance, I don't see we got any alternative, but we go and free our friendly captain and destroy the artillery.
For once, I agree with you.
Hercule?
Oh, I'll fight Alberto Fusa every day I can.
All right. Bill, you're gonna guard Javier on the ship here. Micah, Arthur, let's get to work. Hercule, we follow you.
Anale, this way.
Oh, I got you now, you bastard.
We are all bastards, my friend. But only one of us
is some would-be emperor's whore.
We know who you are.
And nobody knows who you are. Not even your goddamn father.
You maggots are going to die.
Eventually, I'm sure we will. But not today, and not because of you.
The U.S. Navy is on the way.
I am sure they are, which is why you're going to let us leave. Or you are dying right here, my friend.
We've killed better men than you fools.
Enough! Oh, I've had enough of this, Arthur. The rifle?
Sure. Are you men gonna give up? Let us leave? Here! You saved my life. Thank you, Captain.
I suppose you men are my cargo.
Dutch Vanderlyn, I am sorry you got hurt.
Captain's hand.
Let's go. Gentlemen.
I got him for you, Javier.
Captain, can you handle the ship?
I'll be fine. Come on. We'll get going with the tide before I get any more surprise interviews with local officials.
Are you gonna be okay?
We'll be like you. We'll disappear, probably. Back to Haiti. Believe me, we'll be long gone by morning.
Good. Thank you. Oh. We survived.
Just about.
What now?
What now?
What do you mean, what now?
I mean, we're headed back to Lemoyne again, and we're all wanted men.
We slip ashore one by one, find out what's what.
We don't cut and run now? Head back to Blackwater?
No.
Why not?
Because the last thing they'll be thinking is for us to turn up.
We've been on the run for a while now, and it feels like our luck has turned. You know, I ain't turning back. I had a good run of it, I guess.
We ain't even played our hand yet. We just need to put some more money in our pockets. Make our escape. Broke, alone, they're gonna pick us off one by one. And you know it.
Maybe.
Not maybe. We need to split up. Keep a low profile. Try to track down the rest. But carefully. See if they sent any mail. Arthur, you check Shady Bell. We'll find each other eventually. We always do.
And then what?
Then we meet up. We gather the family, we get some money, and get the hell out of there. That's the plan.
We all acting crazy. And that's not what I thought we were gonna be doing here.
We have been in a bad way. Listen. I will kill for my family. Any of you want to judge me for that? That's fine. But that is who I am. Anyone disagree? Anyone?
Stand unshaken, amidst the crash of a world.
sending us back every day to search this place.
There quite clearly isn't a gang of outlaws held up here.
Look, those are fresh footprints. Looks like someone might be here right now.
Sure, someone is here. There's always someone everywhere.
Well, let's look around, then. See if we can find something for Mr. Milton.
Mr. Milton? I'd like to find a poison snake for him.
That's enough, Mr. Johns. You take Mr. Bunter and search around back.
Mr. Orley, let's head inside. Gentlemen, be careful.
Yep.
Come on. That horse don't listen.
Not again. Arthur's here.
Oh, Arthur. Oh, you're alive.
Just about.
Come inside. Come on, it's raining. Hey, everybody, look who's here.
How y'all doing? Hey, old man, wake up.
Hey, Arthur, they got John.
Good to see you.
Yeah, he got arrested.
He ain't hung yet?
Not yet. They moved him to Sisica. He's been working on a chain gang.
Howdy.
Okay.
How'd you folks find each other? What happened? Can somebody get me a cup of coffee or something?
It was Mrs. Adler who saved us, Dutch. After the robbery in Saint-Denis, she got us away from the camp before the Pinkertons turned up. Then Mrs. Adler and Mr. Smith drove away the degenerates of her living here.
Mrs. Adler, we owe you.
Yes. Yes. Yes.
Thank you.
It's been real hard, Dutch. We've been surviving, but only just. What we gonna do?
Things have been tough. There ain't no doubt about that. Trust me. I am gonna get us out of here. This ain't over.
Ain't none of you folks interested in our adventures?
Guess we're more interested in escaping the hangman on our tail?
Cheerful nymph of the prairie, wasn't you, Abigail?
Oh, sure. My fair heart jumps for joy when I set eyes on you, Micah.
We buried Hosea, Dutch. Charles and I stole his body from the law one night and gave him a proper burial. It was real nice.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Well, here you is. Well, I asked everyone I could find, and eventually someone knew, said you fools were out here. Shit. Give me a drink or something.
Get your own damn drink.
In our absence, Mrs. Adler here has been looking after things. Now sit down.
This is Agent Milton with the Pinkerton Detective Agency.
Already?
On behalf of Cornwall Kerosene and Tar, the United States government, and the Commonwealth of West Elizabeth.
Here we go.
We are here to arrest you. Come out with your hands up.
Give them to a count of five, then give them everything. Actually, let them have it.
Let's run! Run, you spineless sons of bitches!
You saved us, Arthur.
Oh, man. Bill and Sadie.
You okay, son?
Sure.
We ain't been back for more than a few days.
What do we do, Dutch?
Clearly, we need to leave. It'll take them some time to regroup. Mr. Pearson, Miss Grimshaw, start packing up. Javier, you and Bill, get out of here. Go scare off any scum still loitering about. We need a couple of days.
Now! Please, gentlemen.
Sure. What next, Dutch?
We just need some time. I need some time. Now, we can't go east, because then we'll be in the ocean, so we're gonna have to go north, I guess. I just need somebody to buy me some goddamn time, one of you.
You'll figure it out, boss. You always do.
What are you gonna do about John, Dutch?
John?
He's in jail.
Well, we'll get him. Abigail, just not yet.
There's talk of hanging him.
It's not gonna come to that.
Dutch!
Not now, Mesa. Not now.
I'm begging you twos. They're gonna hang me, break my... the boy's heart. Please, do something.
We will. Okay. I'm gonna go figure out how we rescue this bastard.
Now?
Yes, now. Give me a Doyle's Tavern on Million Avenue.
Okay. My lord, what a goddamn mess. Everything. Not sure what happens next. Whole thing has been hard on all of us. Most of all on Dutch, who seems half crazed by all we gone through.
So, yep, that was it for this video. I hope you enjoyed this video. I hope you're enjoying these movies, my G's. I'm gonna continue, no worry about GTA 5, Watch Dogs 2 also, and also this game. I want to beat this shit. So yeah, guys, I hope you enjoyed this video. Give it a thumbs up, subscribe if you're new, and hit notification bell so you don't miss any of my videos. Comment right down below when you play next. Thanks for watching, it's your boy X3 Mexcal. I'm out. Peace, your boy is out.